Oh yeah. Who wants to go first?
Raise your hand if you have a question.
I'll go first. Well, I gotta get my microphone here. Okay. Not to ask you just real quick, now you've got so much you know, young talent now in the sector. Some of the younger guys, the mirrors kids, you got 6'3". How many guys have you had with that kind of skill set at that position?
Yeah, he's got rare size, which is a good thing. He's got good length. He's got really good balance and body control. You know, good athletic ability. He runs well, and he loves football. So he's got the talent that we like to work with. He's working really hard at his craft right now, and I'm really proud of about his upside.
Hi, Mel. Wondering if you could just generally assess this defense. Obviously, there's a lot of expectation with a lot of guys coming back, and clearly the safety star seems to be the unanswered question, but I'm sure you have more than that. Can you just kind of assess the expectations and if they're valid?
Yeah, I think we have a lot of returning starters. Like we do, the expectations will be high. But the expectations are going to be high here at UGA every year. So it's really not about that. It's about us living up to our standard and how we want to play and reaching our full potential. I think that our guys right now are working extremely hard to get better at every position. At the star position, we have several guys that are taking reps there. You know, we got Aaron Davis, D'Angelo Gibbs, we've got Tyreek McGee, we have Jarvis Wilson. All those guys are taking reps at that star position, so we're going to figure out who can help us the most there. You know, Mo Smith did a great job for us last year, and we need to replace that spot.
Coach, how is your secondary progress coming into this year with guys like Malcolm Parrish and Dominic Sanders kind of leading the way there?
That's great. Well, you know, you got, like I said, you got Malcolm, you got Dom, you got Aaron Davis, you know, seniors, guys that play a lot of football, that really know what's expected. And I'm leaning on those guys. We're leaning on those guys to be leaders for us back there. You know, DeAndre Baker's got some game experience, and so we're looking to become more cohesive, to work better as a unit. You know, make more plays. I mean, we got seven freshmen, okay, and so we got to teach those guys what to do, and develop these guys, you know, as a unit. Tell them no child left behind. We need to make sure everybody's ready to go by the time that game starts.
Now, when it comes to you know, Tyreek McGee, you know, he's a guy that you said working at star, and it seems like he would also want to be one of the first few corners in the game right now as well too. What's it like trying to balance getting him ready to play both positions? Is he spending more time at one right now than the other?
Well, he did that a year ago, and he played corner on both sides and the star position, and he handled that well. So we just map out his reps every day. You know, we script every rep in practice. A lot of times we're doing two spots, we're working on both fields, and so we've got a lot of guys working at the same time. We just have to make sure he gets his star reps and he gets his corner reps on both sides, and that hasn't been an issue so far.
About the edge rushing, what was your evaluation last year? I mean, obviously sack numbers weren't high, but when it came to affecting the quarterback, QB pressures, what was your evaluation of last year, and how much better they need to do, if any?
Yeah, I think we need to get better pressure overall to affect the quarterback from the edge and also pocket push. We have the guys that can get that done. So I think with a good coordinated pass rush, all four or five guys working together to fill up all the rush lanes, we can get that done. That's a point of emphasis for us. Red zone defense is a area where we need huge improvement. Minus yardage plays, another area where we need huge improvement. So pass rush, red zone efficiency, minus yardage plays, all those things we need to improve.
Kirby was talking earlier about the knee improvement in the red zone.
Yeah.
What do you think was the major breakdown in red zone last year?
Yeah, I think the major breakdown is execution. When you go back and look at the tape, on defense, if one guy does not do what he's supposed to do, you're going to lose it down, probably. And so, it's a huge emphasis on execution. We repped it. We repped the low red zone a lot more in the spring, and we're picking up where we left off this fall. And And so, and obviously there's some scheme things that we're looking at that we can do to help our players. And so, you know, our goal is to be much improved in that area.
Now, those are your years as an assistant coach. What's the closest you've had to what you consider a dominant defense, and what does this unit need to do to get to that level?
Well, I know when I coached at Ohio State, we won national championship. We were pretty good on defense there. In Jacksonville in 2011, I thought we were in the top 10 there. And at Alabama 2 years ago, you know, we were pretty stout there. And so, but it's really about this group and what we can achieve. We talk about what's our identity going to be this year. Every year you have a new team. It's a new defense. So, you know, we're working to be at our best. And I'm pleased with the way the guys have worked. I thought we didn't get as much done yesterday as we could have. So we're looking for a big day today.
Mel, how vital is a guy like John Atkins, who may not put up numbers but has a pretty tough task in that nose guard spot?
Yeah. John, you know, the middle of your defense, you want to be very strong up the middle, just like baseball. So you got to be strong at the defensive tackle, inside linebacker, and safety. You got to be stout. And those guys, he's an anchor force in the middle. He doesn't get a lot of credit. He's not going to be flashy. There's not a lot of fresh pastry right there with him. It's more meat and potatoes. And so as long as he's consistent and he can anchor the middle for us, that's what we need him to do.
So, being an upperclassman, how has Trenton Thompson kind of emerged as a leader amongst the defensive line? And also, how has Trace got kind of come in and help improve his game in the game of others as well?
Yeah, Trenton is a lead by example guy. He brings a tremendous amount of energy to the field. He's very, very disruptive. He runs to the ball, and he's very consistent in that matter. So, and when you have guys that lead by example, that really shows the way for the other guys. Trey Scott has come in and done a tremendous job. He's a technician. He's very good at coaching and teaching in a progression, run and pass rush. And so I think the guys have grown to like him and respect him, and they've taken to him. And I feel like we have a chance to have a strong unit.
Coach, there's been a lot of talk about Roquan Smith already and just kind of his impact on the defense, leadership. You know, can you just talk about him? We asked the players about him the other day, and they kind of lit up. I mean, it seems like he's really, you know, had an impact on this team.
Yeah, Roquan's he's come a long way. And he's playing really, really fast right now. He's showing outstanding leadership for us. He's playing with a lot of confidence. And he's a guy that can make a lot of plays in the run game and as a blitzer and in coverage. And so I just like his ability to be an all-around player. He loves football. He's a student of the game. He's a good leader for us. He has a high character. And he's a guy that's going to lead the way for us. Quite frankly, we're going to need him to be consistent, and I expect him to do that.
Curious about how many guys you want to play typically. I know on defensive line, everyone's subbing as many as you can, but especially in the back end, the other spots, when you have so many returning starters, but you've got so many talented newcomers, how does that affect how many guys you might shuttle in and out?
Yeah, I think in some games last year, we played 18, 19 guys in a game. We need to have a strong 2D in the secondary, especially. We're usually in nickel or dime, probably about 80-90% of the time. So we usually have 5 or 6 defensive backs in the game. So to have a strong, have a lot of depth there, you have to develop the young guys. Those guys have to be ready to go, because it's always, you know, you're one play away from being in the game. It's next man up. We're obviously going to rotate a lot of guys in the defensive line. We want to play as many guys as we can. Guys that have a role, you get more buy-in, you have better team chemistry. So we want to get all these guys ready to play. So as we practice and as we scrimmage, eventually we'll know who we can count on to go out there and play for us, whether they're starters or they're the next man up.